Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation Lecture Series. I, Professor Ipesh Dholakia, is going to explain you anechoic chamber in this session. So to have a measurement of RF radiation of antenna or microwave circuit, we have anechoic chamber, which is been used to have measurement of different parameters regarding RF properties. So to understand this session based on anechoic chamber, these are my session outlines, where in this session, first I'll discuss basics of anechoic chamber. After that, we will see different anechoic chambers with different size. Then after, I'll explain you radiation absorption material, which we use it on the wall of anechoic chamber. So how we can choose that material, what should be the dimension. So all those things that we will discuss in this point. After that, we will see effectiveness over a frequency. So how effectiveness of chamber is varying with respect to frequency. So those points that we will discuss in this session. Then I'll explain you how we can identify size of anechoic chamber with respect to frequency and wavelength. And then at the end, I'll sum up this session by explaining few applications which is there with anechoic chamber. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of anechoic chamber. Now see, as I have told you, for a measurement of RF properties of antennas and microwave circuits or microwave components, that is been carried out in anechoic chamber. So we used to have RF measurement of antennas and microwave component measurement in anechoic chamber. And usually when we design chamber has been designed by keeping in mind of requirements of UHF RFID system components. So ultra high frequency RFID system components were been keeping in mind before we design that chamber. We can also use anechoic chamber for different purposes, like we can have antenna measurements, we can have monostatic or bistatic radar cross section measurement. So for radar cross section, monostatic, bistatic radar cross section measurement, we can have anechoic chamber. Near field measurement is even been getting done in anechoic chamber. Bore side measurement is even done in anechoic chamber, as well as return loss characteristics could be measured in anechoic chamber. As well as there are few more purpose which is there with anechoic chamber. Like you might have seen, sound measurement is even done in anechoic chamber to avoid reflections from the wall. So anechoic chamber is nothing, it is a room which is specifically designed to avoid internal reflection, as well as exterior sound or exterior RF interference should not happen inside the room. And for that, there are few things which we need to take care, and that will get stick on the wall of that anechoic chamber, so that those unwanted signal will not affect to the measurement with given system. So see, anechoic chamber is a room that is designed to absorbs reflection of EM waves as well as sound. So for sound measurement even, we need to avoid that reflection which happens from the wall, as well as in electromagnetic waves, there will be reflection from the wall. So this chamber has been designed in such a way that there will be no reflection inside. There are also often isolated from waves entering from their surrounding. Like see, if you have a chamber over here, and you will be finding, like right now, if you keep a spectrum analyzer and vector analyzer at outside, then you will be finding it will measure so many signals which is happening in their surrounding outside the room, and that will be affecting measurement inside the room. So we need to isolate all those waves which is happening in surrounding of that room, and that is even one purpose which we need to keep in our mind. RF anechoic chamber eliminates reflection and external noise caused by electromagnetic waves. So here two things that we need to do. One is internal reflection inside room, as well as it should avoid external noise which is happening outside the room. Anechoic chamber ranges from small component of size of microwave cone to one as large as aircraft hangar. So I'll show you different anechoic chamber with different size. So it will gives you idea like how we do measurement. For small components like microstrip antenna, small anechoic chambers are required. But for large size devices like aircraft, there will be huge anechoic chamber where we do RF measurement of devices. The size of chamber depends on size of object as well as range of frequency. So when we design chamber at that time, these are the things which we need to keep in our mind. Like what will be the size of object for which we do RF measurement. And secondly, we need to see at what frequency that device is functioning. And based on that, size of chamber varies. So all those things in detail, we will see step by step. So let me show you first different anechoic chamber. So it will give you idea about how those things are there. So see here, one can see one anechoic chamber is there, and as I have discussed earlier, on the wall we have radiation absorbed material. So that is having pyramidal shape. That is what we stick it on the wall so that there will be minimum reflection inside, and that will not affect to this device. So when you measure this device with different characteristics, at that time radiation happens from this device and that will go on the wall, and that should not come back to this device again, else there will be error in measurement. And to avoid this reflection on the wall, there will be radiation absorption material, and that will not allow reflected signal to come back over here on this device. As well as when we talk about this chamber, at that time in surroundings even there will be so many noise outside the room, and that should even not enter inside so that we can have proper measurement of device which we have it in this chamber. And you can see now I have shown bit bigger anechoic chamber where you can see this car, and this car is electronic car, where in this car there are many components which is functioning in terms of gigahertz of frequencies, and for that measurement we are having this chamber. And as this chamber is large, you will be finding there are different frequency range, different frequency measurement will happen. It will start from low frequency to high frequency, and usually for low frequency measurement, size of chamber will increase. And you can see one more chamber that I have shown for helicopter measurement. This is the chamber that we have, and this will be even bigger chamber than previous one which we have discussed. So I think now it will be clear to all, like based on the size of object, size of chamber is there, right? But now how, based on the size of frequency, chamber is there. So that is even the agenda which we need to understand, and that I'll explain you step by step. So see, radiation absorption material, as I have told you earlier, radiation absorption material that we stick it on the wall of chamber so that we avoid reflection from the wall. So if you see the material shape, then you will be finding it is pyramidal cone, where base is square. You can see base is square and shape is pyramidal cone, and this shape that avoids maximum reflection. Now here are two things that we need to keep in our mind. One is base size and one is height size of this pyramidal cone. So how those things are there, let us try to understand step by step. See, radiation absorption material, in short it is referred as RAM, is designed and shaped to absorb incident RF radiation which happens on this material, right? And it will be having maximum effect as if signal is reflected normally on this material. So if signal is normally coming on this material, then its effect will be maximum. So the more effective RAM, lower the resulting level of reflected RF radiation. So if we have effective radiation absorption material, then minimum reflection will happen from this material. So many measurement in electromagnetic compatibility and in antenna radiation pattern requires spurious signal from test setup, including reflection from negligible, to avoid risk of causing measurement error and ambiguities. So during the measurement, you'll be finding from test setup, from device, as well as from cabling, there will be radiation, and that radiation will affect measurement data. And that effect will be more as if there will be reflection from the wall of chamber. So here we use radiation absorption material on the wall so that we can avoid internal reflection from the wall, and we can reduce measurement error, which we do it in chamber. Now we will see how effectiveness is there with respect to frequency. So see, waves of higher frequency has shorter wavelength and higher energy, while lower frequency is having longer wavelength and lower in energy according to lambda is equals to V by F, where V is velocity and F is frequency. So we can say if frequency is higher, then wavelength is lower, and if frequency is lower, then wavelength is higher. To shield for a specific wavelength, cone must be appropriate size to absorb the wavelength. So here we need to observe that pyramidal cone size, and based on size we can absorb specific wavelengths. The performance quality of RF anechoic chamber is determined by its lowest test frequency of operation, at which measured reflection from the internal surface will be the most significant compared to higher frequency. So quality of performance of anechoic chamber is been determined by lowest frequency at which minimum reflection happens, and lower the frequency of reflection due to absorption by radiation absorption material, we define performance quality. So here our agenda should be to absorb minimum frequency to maximum frequency, and main challenges are there at minimum frequency. As if you use lower frequency, in that case we need to increase height of the radiation absorption material. See, pyramidal radiation absorption material is most absorptive when incident wave is at normal incidence to the internal chamber surface, and pyramidal height is approximately equal to lambda by 4. So if you see this pyramidal shape, right, then if you increase height, right, then you can absorb lower frequencies, as height is approximately lambda by 4. So as earlier I have told, lower the frequency, higher the wavelength. Higher the wavelength, higher the height of radiation absorption material. So what will happen is, like, as if you increase height of radiation absorption material, total volume required to have those pyramidal cone will increase, and that will even increase cost of the chamber, as well as that will decrease internal available size. Like you can see, initially the size of room is this, and on the wall we stick material, and if you increase height of that pyramidal cone, then total available volume to use that radiation measurement will decrease. As well as here, that is been depending on material height which we use, and that material height is depending on frequency. So lower the frequency of absorption, higher the height of pyramidal cone. So accordingly, increasing pyramidal height of RAM for base size improves effectiveness of chamber at low frequencies, but that results into increased cost and reduced unrobustruct working volume that is available inside the chamber of defined size. So as I have told you, like, see, in room we need to observe what should be the available space for measurement and what should be the range of frequency. So if you want to lower the reflection with lower frequency, in that case we need to increase volume of that radiation absorption material, which will increase cost of the room, as well as that will provide lower space for measurement. Now let us discuss applications which is there with anechoic chamber. So see, measurement of RF properties of antennas, for that purpose even we use anechoic chamber. For measurement of UHF RFID system component, we have anechoic chamber. For monostatic and bistatic radar cross section measurement, we have anechoic chamber. Near field measurement, near field radiation measurement even done in anechoic chamber. Bore side measurement is been done in anechoic chamber. For radon testing, we use anechoic chamber. So these are the applications which is there with anechoic chamber. I hope that you have understood this session based on anechoic chamber. Now I think it will give you idea about what should be the size of anechoic chamber with respect to frequency, as earlier I have discussed. See, lower the measurement of frequency, bigger the size of radiation absorption material, and bigger the size of radiation absorption material, you will be finding cost of the room will increase, and that will provide you lower space in anechoic chamber. So see, these are the things which we need to keep in mind. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will solve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.